Now, as the jets go upside down, boys and girls, listen to them, I see you waving. Back in 1964 for their first season in 1965. The aircraft they used was the Holland Gnat. That was the predecessor to the Hawk and was the... They're about to form a very wide shape now. Red 8 and 9 will move to the outside of the formation. And from Red 9's left wingtip through to Red 8's right wingtip, the formation now measures 100 metres or 300 feet. Now, to enable the formation to stay as one as they manoeuvre around the sky, the outside pilots really have to anticipate their control inputs. To enable them to do that, they use the cadence in Red 1's voice commands. But now, they form that wide formation. We're going to have some very patriotic red, white and blue, and hopefully a huge round of applause as they show you Phoenix! Is it Red 1's voice? On the leader's right wing is Red 2. He's one of our first year pilots this year. He's Red 2 flight attendant Stu Campbell. He's a former Tucano instructor, having taught basic fast jet training and also displayed the Tucano aircraft. Operationally, he flew the Tornado GR4. Out to the right, the smoke's on, the boys are forming our trademark shape. In a true 1960s and 70s style, all nine jets are now going to put their smoke on as they fly the Diamond Roll. Another big wave, boys and girls! The majority of our formations with the odd-numbered pilots on the left-hand side, the even-numbered pilots fly on the right-hand side. In their three-year tour with the team, the pilots will generally start at the front near the leader, and as their proficiency improves, they move further back. They pull up at 4G and 400 miles an hour. Another shape, this time of feathered arrow. And as they reach the top of this loop, they're at about 5,500 to 6,000 feet. The jets have slowed down to about 150 miles an hour. The G's backed off to around 1G. As they apex the loop and start coming down the other side, the speed's building up to 400 miles an hour. The G's building up to 4G. They're in that feathered arrow shape. That's a mouthful to say on the radio. So we call this Fred. That's the end of the first half of the Renaro's display, ladies and gentlemen, where you've seen all nine aircraft performing close formation aerobatics. We're now going to split down into sections of 2, 3, 4, 5 or 7 aircraft and show you some more dynamic manoeuvring. Please keep your eyes on the synchro pair with the blue smoke underneath. This is the palm split. Lovely wife. Dixon formation. He's now twisting this loop towards us through 90 degrees in a quarter clover. Get your cameras ready. Leaders benefit, and they're drawing a red, white and blue snake-like shape of smoke in the sky in the Python. On the far right of that, this is the corkscrew. As they fly past upside down. Red 6 gives the command for the formation to widen as they roll out in a four ship square card formation. This is the Twister! Busy with the red smoke on his red flying, he's Flight Lieutenant Steve Morris. Steve's in his second year with the team. He's a former Hawk flying instructor, and then operationally he's flown both the Harrier GR9 and the Tornado GR4 before donning his red suit for the first time last year. Now look directly above the air. Brake! Team, the Rados!